Good morning. Welcome to the celebration of the Eucharist. Please take this time to silence your cell phones and all electronic devices. Our gathering song is number 604, All the Ends of the Earth, number 604. Please join in singing as we rise. All the ends of the earth, the creatures of the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders of the Lord, for the Lord of the earth, the master of the sea, has come with justice for the world. Break into song of the deeds of the Lord, the wonders he has done.
Of the earth, all you creatures of the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders of the Lord, for the Lord of the earth, the master of the sea, has come with justice for the world.
Don't know if you've had the chance to meet Aniel. Aniel is filling in for Peter while Peter is recovering from surgery. He had hernia surgery yesterday, and he's gonna be out a good 6 weeks. And so we have a filler inner. So welcome, we thank you for stepping forward for that. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you are the Lamb of God who takes away our sins. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you make your dwelling among us. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you lead us to the heavenly city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who made your people partakers in your redemption, grant, we pray, that we may perpetually render thanks for the resurrection of the Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Paul left Athens and went to Corinth. There he met a Jew named Aquila, a native of Pontus, who had recently come from Italy with his wife Priscilla, because Claudius had ordered all the Jews to leave Rome. He went to visit them, and because he practiced the same trade, stayed with them and worked, for they were tent makers by trade. Every Sabbath, he entered into discussions in the synagogue, attempting to convince both Jews and Greeks. When Silas and Timothy came down from Macedonia, Paul began to occupy himself totally with preaching the word, testifying to the Jews that the Christ was Jesus. When they opposed him and reviled him, he shook out his garments and said to them, "Your blood be on your heads. I am clear of responsibility. From now on, I will go to the Gentiles." So he left there and went to a house belonging to a man named Titus Justus, a worshiper of God. His house was next to a synagogue. Crispus, the synagogue official, came to believe in the Lord along with his entire household, and many of the Corinthians who heard, believed, and were baptized. The word of the Lord. The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done wondrous deeds. His right hand has won victory for him, his holy arm. The Lord has made his salvation known. In the sight of the nations, he has revealed his justice. He has remembered his kindness and his faithfulness toward the house of Israel. All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation by our God. Sing joyfully to the Lord, all you lands. Break into song, sing praise.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you.
Jesus said to his disciples, "A little while and you will no longer see me. And again, a little while later and you will see me." So some of the disciples said to one another, "What does this mean that he is saying to us? A little while and you will not see me. And again, a little while, and you will see me, and because I am going to the Father." So they said, "What is this little while of which he speaks? We do not know what he means." Jesus knew that they wanted to ask him, so he said to them, "Are you discussing with one another what I said? A little while, and you will not see me, and again, in a little while, you will see me." Amen, amen, I say to you, you will weep and mourn while the world rejoices. You will grieve, but your grief will become joy. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In today's Gospel, we hear Jesus say, a little while and you will no longer see me. And again, a little while later, you will see me again. Are you confused? This absolutely confused the mud out of his disciples. The disciples were like many of us who could not comprehend words of time like the words Jesus used a little while. Human thoughts of time are nothing like Jesus' thoughts of time. Our readings both speak about time today, how time is spent, and what time means to the world. So I'm going to start with as many words that I could think of when I was writing this that have to do with time. And I'm sure that as I read this, you'll have some also to add to it. You can tell me later. We have what time we have. What time is it? Time out. Time to get a new one. Well, it's about time. Timing is everything. Time in a bottle. Time will tell. And of course, the one that I heard the most growing up, how many times do I have to tell you? Mom said, I'm getting blue in the face. I said, that's terrible. You shouldn't do that. I am sure there's many more that you will probably are asking about time. And why is Deacon Joe even talking about time today? Because our idea of time matters less than we think. God's time matters the most. Rome was not built in a day, right? But if it had been up to God, it could have been in God's time. Think about that. When you get frustrated that the things do not happen as fast as you would like, time can mean different things for different people. Yet we do not know what time is for God, because God's time cannot be defined by the human mind. We have very little understanding. Let's talk about what we think we know about time. We cannot really see time, and yet it controls every aspect of our daily lives. We can see the effects of time as we age, as the grass grows, when it gets light, and when it gets dark. But we cannot actually see time, can we? The whole world believes in time, but they cannot see it, even though they see the effects of time. Yet there are many people in this world that say, we cannot see God, but close their eyes to the effects of God because they do not believe in God. So pray for those people. As I mentioned above, time has a different meaning for us. God created the world in 6 days, rested on the seventh. Moses wandered in the wilderness forever. But for God, it was a little time. Jesus was crucified, died, and was buried, and arose on the third day. Is that our time? Or was that God's time? Our first reading this morning deals with several things for Paul, and knowing how precious time is, he decides to quit wasting time on those crazy Jews and Greeks trying to convert them and start spreading the gospel to the Gentiles. You see, Paul was convinced that the second coming was going to be in his lifetime, and he needed to reach out to as many people before that time was up. Paul was guilty, just as we are, thinking that our time is the same as God's time. Jesus did say, a little while and you will no longer see me, and again in a little while later you will see me again, in which Paul interpreted as any day now, we will see him again. In Matthew 25:13, Jesus said that he would return, but warned the world we would not know the hour or the day. God's time. Be prepared. Paul was right in thinking that he should convert as many people as he could, just as we should. The Holy Spirit kept Paul energized and full of emotion so that he would continue the mission that Christ started. But time was not what was important. It was his message. The gospel that he preached is what mattered. So what real effects does time have on the human race today? Would you agree that we live in a society that we call instant gratification? If you're not sure what that means, and I would like to explain it a little bit, it's I want it, and I want it now. It's mine, I can't wait, it's time that I have it now. We live in a world that believes there's never enough time either, right? Have you ever been on a week's vacation and on the last day you go, really, it's over already? How about living through an illness or waiting for an answer from a doctor or thinking, why is time going so slow? Or really, how much more time is Deacon going to preach? We let time control our thoughts, our lives, and our words. We worry about things we cannot control. We're like the little rabbit in Alice in Wonderland, running around. What time is it? Just like the disciples in the gospel today, we understand very little about Jesus' language. But we do understand that we will see him again. Jesus said there is time for mourning, and there will be time for rejoicing. We live each day counting the hours. Can we take a breath in saying things will happen in God's time? Will you allow that to happen? The reality is we as humans do not have control over time. But just as Paul did, we do have control over our message. Remember, it's in God's time.
Trusting in the promises of God, let us bring our needs and intentions before him this day.
For all members of the church, may we be empowered by the Holy Spirit in preaching the good news to all, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For rulers of nations, may the Lord raise up courageous, honest, and forthright men and women to hold these positions of power, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who struggle with doubt or to understand God's movement in their lives, may they be led to deeper trust through Christ's love, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this faith community, may God console us in our struggles and fill us with his love, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those whom we promise to pray and for the prayers we hold in the depths of our hearts, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Danny Barrera and all who have passed away, may they rejoice in the presence of God in heaven, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Did you do this one?
Got the wrong intention, my apologies. For Joseph K. Hewley and all who have passed away, may they rejoice in the presence of God in heaven, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Faithful God, hear the prayers that we offer you this day. For in our time, we expect your love. We also know it because we experience it as we love one another through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for it's through your goodness we have the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.